You're in trouble.
Okay, well, so I am, as I said, the census liaison for Cole County. We are partnered with Jefferson City, and Katrina Williams is my counterpart in the city, so she's also a liaison. So we have what we're calling a complete count committee. These are committees that the Census Department has asked communities to set up to try and get the word out to some of the undercounted areas of our community. So I'll go into more about that later on in the presentation. But first I'm going to play a little video about what the census is. Let's see. Maybe. How do I put some? See if it works. It may not work. If it doesn't, we'll just move it all on.
Beginning in March, the U.S. Census Bureau will invite households across the country to participate in the 2020 census. But what is the census? Simply put, the census is a headcount of every person living in the United States. To be sure the government represents the people, the U.S. Constitution requires a population count every 10 years. The U.S. Census ever since 1790, promises has determined the number of states in the 2020 census in the U.S. House of Representatives. Simply put, it is census is a headcount of every person. To be sure the government represents the people, the U.S. Constitution requires a population count every 10 years. Ever since 1790, the census has determined the number of seats each state receives in the U.S. House of Representatives.
Okay, I found it.
It.
Here we go.
Okay. Beginning in March, the U.S. Census Bureau will invite households across the country to participate in the 2020 census. But what is the census? Simply put, the census is a headcount of every person living in the United States. To be sure the government represents the people, the U.S. Constitution requires a population count every 10 years. Ever since 1790, the census has determined the number of seats each state receives in the U.S. House of Representatives. It is, and always has been, a cornerstone of our democracy. We still use it to determine representation. But leaders also use the data to make decisions. Your response helps guide planning for the future of our communities. The 2020 census will help inform decisions on how billions of dollars are allocated annually for critical public services like roads, schools, hospitals and healthcare clinics, fire and emergency response services, and hundreds of other programs. In 2020, for the first time, you'll be able to complete the census online, by phone or by mail. It asks a few simple questions, like how many people live in your home on April 1st, including their age and sex, and if there are any children living there. You should know that by law, all census responses are completely confidential, and your personal information cannot be shared with any law enforcement agencies. Every person counts, no matter who you are or where you live. So whether your family has participated for decades, or the 2020 census will be your first, we all have a role in shaping the future of our country.
Quick, can you explain what the census is?
Can you explain this to me?
It happens every 10 years and affects every person in the U.S. Anything?
As it said, it's the U.S. mandates The goal is to count where you live and sleep most of the time on April 1st. So, you know, some people, like you would talk about, you know, you have two residences, where should you be counted? It's wherever you are staying most of the time on April 1st is where you should be counted. So there are some major changes in 2020. This will be the first year that you will be able to do the census online. You can respond online by phone or by mail. And the caveat to the mail part is you will not get an actual paper form unless you do not respond. Like, they'll send you like 5 invitations to respond, and if you don't respond, that last mailing will be the paper form. Only 20% nationally of people will get a paper form, and those are going to be primarily in the areas that don't have good internet access. So that's kind of important to know. Most everybody will need to respond online or by phone.
Can I ask a question, or are you going to wait?
Yeah.
So if you respond, like I got mine yesterday,
yeah.
If I respond now, am I still going to get 4 more?
No. Attention? Once you've responded, you shouldn't get any more invitations.
Okay. Thank you.
So
you got to choose by phone.
I mail. Yeah, and everybody should be getting, in the next few days, you should be getting an envelope like this, and this is your invitation to respond, and it'll have the information on where you go online to respond, or the phone number that you will respond to. I got mine yesterday. They told us that this week is pretty much when most of them will be going out. Most everything will be going out. You won't be able to go to, say, the library. I think 10 years ago, you could go to the library and pick up a paper form. You won't be able to do that this year. So it's very important for our federal funding. $675 billion annually in federal funding are distributed based on population. Here in Missouri, for every child and adult not counted, we stand to lose $1,300 a year in federal funds, so that adds up to, you know, can add up to quite a bit. It's also important for redistricting, forecasting for transportation, housing, rehabilitation loans, planning, you know, helping people with disabilities. There's so many different things that we get federal funding for that this is really important for. So how does the census impact your community? Like I said, you know, if you think about your morning commute, you know, grants for buses, street repairs, you know, schools, you know, the Head Start program, the free lunch program, different programs like that, Head Start, wildlife disaster response. We had the tornado, you know, we the emergency responders use a lot of grant money to buy things for emergency response. So, you know, that's another big one. So who should be counted? This is an important one because I think a lot of people don't really understand who should be counted and where. So you want to make sure anybody that is living in your home and sleeping there most of the time on April 1st is counted. So there's a list of, you know, those people. Newborns, if they're born on or before April 1st, count them. If, you know, you're a grandmother that's raising your grandkids, you count them. Or if you are somebody who has friends living at your house on April 1st, you count those friends and their kids. So if they're living in your house on April 1st, then you would count them. If you have kids in college that are living at the dorm, you don't count them if they're not staying with you, if they're not living with you. Those are considered group quarters. And there's a special count for those circumstances. Same goes with nursing homes, you know, correctional facilities, things like that. Those are counted as group quarters. Confidentiality. They are really serious about confidentiality. I have to send them our address list and match and kind of tell them new addresses. When they send me their data, I have to sign a paper saying that under, you know, threat of arrest, I will not share that data out with anyone. So they are very serious about that. So, you know, they are always pushing and letting people know that this data is confidential. They don't share it. They're not going to share it with law enforcement. They're not going to share it with anybody. So, like I said, you need to look for your invitation. They are sending out the first round right now. If you don't respond, you'll get another one. It says March 16th through 24th, but probably in the next week or two, they'll send a second round, I would think. Then you'll start getting reminder postcards, and then in April, mid-April, you'll probably get your paper form if you haven't responded by then. And then, you know, you're moving into around May when the census takers will be coming to your door and you know, trying to get the count that way. Like I said, it is a mandate, so, you know, everybody should be responding. And this is just a timeline kind of showing kind of the calendar of how this all goes. April 1st is officially Census Day. It's just kind of a day that that the census has picked to kind of promote it, and also the day that you're supposed to count where you are on that day. So everything should be done by the end of the year, and then in March of next year, redistricting summaries will be sent out to local, to all the states, and then that data can be used for redistricting and things like that. So what questions will be asked? There are 9 questions for each person living in the household. So it's not a long form, but you know, if you have 5 kids, you're going to have to fill it out 5 different forms. But we will have assistance for anyone who needs help filling out their form. We have 2 spots that are kind of set right now. Jefferson City, if you go to the lower level there, they will have someone there that can help fill out your form. And the library is going to be one of the locations if somebody needs help. We will have other locations. We'll be announcing a little bit later in the future. We have our complete count committee is coming up with some locations. We really want to make sure that the people that we have manning those locations are trained to know, because the people that are working those locations can't, if someone is there and saying something, to put something down on their form, and you know, well, that can't be right, you can't just change it. You know, you have to put what they tell you and things like that. So we do have a document that kind of goes through how to help people fill those forms out. So, I know I would open this, but I'm afraid it's going to break. But it's just, if you go to the census website, they have a sample form that you can look at, and I'll have links to that on the last page if anybody wants to take a screenshot or a picture of it. One thing that we're really wanting to put in people's minds is to watch out for scams. Census workers are not going to ask for your social security number, they're not going to ask for your bank accounts, they're not going to ask for donations or any money of any kind. So, you know, just be aware. And also make sure, you know, if they come to your door, you can check for their badge. They will have a badge on, and it'll have their photograph And if you have any doubts at all about it, there's an 800 number that you can call to report and kind of ask them, and they'll be able to verify if that is an actual census worker. But what they've tried to do is hire people from the community, so hopefully, you know, since it'll be community members, maybe some people will recognize those people less.
So when will those people go out if you don't return a survey, or how does that work?
Yeah, if you don't return the survey, then those people will start going out, I believe it's in May, and going door to door and trying to get those addresses that didn't respond. So how can you help? Well, we have a complete count committee that everybody is welcome to join. We've been meeting once a month. I think we may ramp it up a little bit since the time is kind of coming to fill it out. We meet down at the city, and we have a calendar on, we have a census website, 2020 census on colecounty.org. colecounty.org/2020census, and that information will be on the slide also coming up. But we have another meeting coming up later in this month. I don't have the date right in my head. We are urging people to, you know, share out social media. There's a lot of social media graphics that you can share out. Right now I've got a frame on my social media profile picture with the 2020 census on it. There are some social media graphics where you can challenge somebody to fill out the census. Cole County has a Facebook page, and if you follow that Facebook page, there are also, I'm putting out those social media graphics pretty regularly. People probably get tired of seeing them. So you could share those out. Presentations, if you have an organization that, you know, you would like to have somebody do a presentation for, we have several people on the committee that can do that, or, you know, we can give you the information to do it. Tell your friends and neighbors and coworkers and family members to take the census, and of course respond to the census.
Now, is that different languages?
They have all languages, and I actually have materials in Spanish and English.
So. And the people that are assigned these areas that are going to help,
bilingual?
Yeah.
What they've been looking for are bilingual people, so I don't know how many of those people are bilingual, I know that they've been really trying to find people that are bilingual to help with that. But I do know that we are looking at some locations for helping people with their census form that will be able to help bilingually. And the census department does have resources to help people with
So on the voluntary side, I speak Spanish. I'm fluent in both languages. Spanglish, I call it. If there's an interest, I'd love to.
Oh, yeah, yeah. We'd love to have you at our next meeting. I will look it up and let you know. That'd be great.
There you go, Chris. Another thing for you. You heard it here first. Everybody volunteered me.
As you've probably seen around town, we've been really pushing census jobs. The census has been hiring. They needed 600 plus workers for the Cole County area. So we've been really pushing it. But probably this month will be the last big push. We need about 35 more applicants. It's a really great temporary opportunity, $17 an hour plus mileage. They train you. They pay for your, you to go get your fingerprints and background check done. 20-40 hours a week. And so we're going to have two more hiring events on March 21st and March 26th to try and get those 35 last positions filled. And so if you know anybody who's looking for a part-time job, that's a good, that'll be a good opportunity.
Would it be mostly daytime or evening?
It's flexible. Because, you know, most people work, so a lot of the census takers will be going out after work, you know, to try and catch those people. Yeah, so, yeah, it's going to be a great part-time job. And this kind of just explains what the complete count committee is and what it does. We are really focused on, but there are a couple areas in our community that are were low count areas at the last census. They determined that they were low count areas. One of them is kind of the Jefferson City downtown area, Ward 1 area. And the other area that was kind of a low count committee, our low count area was the kind of the Westview Heights area in Cole County. So we're really trying to get the word out to those communities to get out and do their census. Cole County as a whole wasn't really bad on the low count, but just those areas kind of are areas that were lower. There are definitely a lot more communities that are worse at having people fill out the census in Cole County, but you know, we want to make sure that everybody is counting, so it's really important. And then here are the resources that I talked about. There, the response outreach area mapper that's listed there, that's an interactive map that shows the locale areas and where they are. There's a document there on that you can download that shows where the federal funds are distributed if you're interested in knowing kind of where the money goes. Our Cole County Jefferson City census page is up there. That's where we're posting materials and information, and a calendar is there. A lot of good information. So, and then the census website, like I said, they have a ton of like documents and stuff that are easy to distribute. And I encourage you also to talk to your employees too, and kind of spread the word in your business and let them know, you know, this is important. And that's all I have.
I have a couple of questions. You mentioned that some of this information has already been mailed out, correct?
The first invitation has been mailed.
If they respond, or if we respond now, will they take it since it's not April 1st?
Yes.
We have to wait till after it.
No, they started taking it yesterday.
Okay.
They opened it yesterday. So, I mean, if you know you're not going to be going anywhere.
Secondly, I work with a group of pastors. It's the Old Ministerial Alliance.
Uh-huh.
Is it possible, because we are meeting on Thursday, is it possible for me to get a number of these? Because I think this is pretty good information.
Yeah, I can probably make some copies. They won't be the super glossy ones from the census. We've been trying to get more of the census.
Well, or I can also send, I have about, I don't know, 30 or 40 email of pastors around the community. Okay, it's the Jefferson City area.
Yeah.
So I could email it out as well if I can get it. So.
Okay. Yeah, I know we have Reverend Cassandra Gold from Faith Voices, and she's a member of our committee, and she's been doing a lot with the churches. But
okay, well, no, I just want to make sure.
All of the, you know, people that we can get to send out, the better.
Well, that's a good source.
Yeah.
If they just put it in the bulletin.
Yeah.
Of, you know, please.
Sam Bushman, he's been talking about, you know, getting it out to the Catholic churches, because he's involved with the Catholic churches, and, you know, putting stuff in the bulletin is one of the things that he's been talking about. So I'm actually actually going to be getting the material for him to put into the bulletin for that.
So. Okay, well, if you could email me that.
Yeah,
because,
I'll get your contact information. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And anybody who needs any kind of information like that, you know, the email address 2020completecount@cocaddy.org will come to myself and Katrina Williams. And if there's any information that you need, we can get that to you. There's a ton of material for Census Bureau's done a really good job of putting together lots of graphics and materials, and also, you know, lining out exactly what we need to do to get the word out. So.
Thank you.
Thank you.